I have a nephew who likes fishing, so when I find fish-related products, I end up buying them for him. I found this cute shark bag after Halloween for $1. This bag is probably for Halloween candy and not sturdy enough for everyday use. But this bag is so cute and unusual that I think I will repurpose this cute bag to a laptop sleeve. As you can see, the handles are only lightly sewn onto the bag, so I removed the handles from the bag. This fabric is a bit thin, so I will attach a fusible interface onto this fabric to make it stronger. Over with parchment paper to prevent direct contact with the iron adhesive. Hold the iron in the same position for about 10 seconds before lifting the iron and moving to the next position. Do not glide with the iron as it may cause the two fabrics and interfaces to shift and not match. Since the main fabric was ready-made, it was slightly off, so I took the seam allowance and made an exact rectangle. The main fabric has been interfaced, but it still feels weak and thin for a laptop sleeve, so I would add reinforcement by using flex foam. Place the main fabric on top, with the wrong side facing down onto the sticky side of the flex form. Iron in the same way I did with the interfacing. I found an anchor patterned fabric at Dollar Tree. This is perfect for lining the shark pattern sleeve. However, I wanted the anchor pattern facing down, so I needed two of these fabrics. If the pattern has a direction, make sure it is in the right direction. This fabric has a long pile, so the stitch line can be hidden by lightly scratching the pile with a fingernail. finally finished it. I used interfacing and foam because this fabric was too thin for a laptop cover. Using a lining, we can transform this flimsy bag into a functional sturdy bag or laptop sleeve. This method can be applied to other similar bags as well. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and stay tuned to the next video.
Thank you for watching. See ya!